yun nga, medyo hirap ako makipagkaibigan, mag-reach out. It's really a challenge, especially na because of my work as a politician.
Yeah.
So, it's a everyday challenge for me. Na ganun yung personality ko.
Mayor Sarah, you appear to be very soft-spoken, yet we all know that you are also very fierce. Do you see yourself as someone who speaks softly but carries a big stick?
Actually, yung totoo talaga, I'm quite shy and reserved.
Oh, okay.
Of course, my friends would say that, oh, no, she's not shy, but I talk when I am with friends, but with acquaintances and strangers, I'm usually nagka-clam up ako. So, yan yung isa sa mga challenges ko. And then, another thing is, meron ko stage fright.
Really?
Yes. Severe. Oo nga, no? Hindi niyo napapansin. No, I have severe stage fright na tulad nito. I don't usually do interviews, but I did this for you because I wanted to thank you for all your help to our President Duterte, no? Kasi yun nga, grabe yung stage fright ko, and it takes a big effort for me to speak, to talk, to go on stage, to talk to people. So malaki na effort yon sa akin. Through the years, natutunan ko na rin siya medyo i-refine, but I'm sure yung mga people who see through yung persona ko on stage would see na medyo anxious ako, pinapawisan lagi, ganun, because of the stage fright.
This is quite a revelation, kasi we have always seen you as very fierce, very confident, and you know, I invited you for our last session about being alpha personality, and then, pero how do you manage this? Because you're always like in the face of the public, so how do you balance yung? I think this is gonna be helpful for a lot of people who has anxiety problem facing the public. How do you handle this anxiety, Mayor Sarah?
I just suck it all up and then put a face and then go out there. I have to share this with you, an experience of mine. So I was a neophyte. Hindi na rin ako neophyte nun because I was already running for mayor, and in one of the campaign rallies, sa sobrang hindi ko naayos yung sa loob ko, I was talking incoherently, I was not making sense, and nalilimutan ko kung ano yung mga points and na dapat ko sabihin. Na after the campaign, after the rally, my President Duterte really talked to me. Sabi niya sa akin, are you drunk? Sabi ko, no, are you, what is wrong with you? Sabi ko, hindi ko so, of course, my father has a very strong personality, and I'm sure wala siyang stage fright. So hindi ko masabi sa kanya noon. And then he told me na, look at this person, look at this candidate, look at this person. Kita mo ba siya? Mas magaling pa siya sa iyo eh. Ganyan. So yun.
Ano ka lang talaga?
I'm soft-spoken because I'm very reserved na tao, and malaki yung stage fright ko talaga. So that when I go out, it is really an effort sa akin na magsalita, makipag-converse, to carry a conversation, especially with acquaintances and strangers. With friends, wala naman problema eh, kasi kaibigan.
So do you consider yourself as an introvert rather than extrovert?
In a sense na I do not easily make friends. Siguro, yes, oo. Kasi my circle of friends are very small dahil yun nga medyo hirap ako makipagkaibigan, mag-reach out. It's really a challenge, especially na because of my work as a politician.
Yeah.
So it's a everyday challenge for me. Na ganun yung personality ko, and yet the demands of my work is quite the opposite.
As a mayor, aren't you expected to like interact with people a lot? I think more than any politicians, right? Na kasi you are in the city, yan yung parang the highest government official na accessible sa mga citizens. So how do you manage that you interact with people every day? And parang naisip ko yun na parang napakahirap for you.
Yes, kung makikita niyo yung the way I am in 2007 and the way I am ngayon 2020, malaki na rin yung nagawa ko to improve that part of me na mag-adjust ako. Kailangan ko mag-adjust para sa trabaho.
You might be the first politician who admits na meron kayong stage fright. Then pa na ano na you are the presidential daughter. So I can imagine na that would also add to your anxiety kasi nga 'di ba iba na yung dati Davao lang kayo ngayon it's the entire Philippines. So what advice can you give to people who are dealing with anxiety?
That, well, number one, you have to focus on what you do, so it will be a challenge and a limitation for you to be efficient and effective if you allow that fear, that anxiety to rule you. So dapat isipin mo talaga na there is something that I have to do and I have to do this very good. So as I said kanina, sabi ko, you really have to suck it up, ilagay mo sa isang box and then itago mo yung box and then you just open it pag wala ka na, tapos na yung kailangan mo gawin. And then one thing also I learned through the years, kapag pinapawisan na ako and yung heartbeat ko, naririnig ko na sa ears ko, yeah, hindi na ako makapag-isip ng maayos.
So, ganun talaga yung anxiety nyo na you hear your heartbeat na?
Panic, yes. Oo, yung panic. And I learned that 10 deep breaths will calm you down.
10 deep breaths.
Okay. Yes, oo. So, usually yan din ang ginagawa ko before I go on stage. So deep breaths, 10, and I learned na medyo bumabagal yung pintig ng puso. So medyo kumakalma.
So yun ang ritual ninyo para magkalma kayo sa inyong anxiety.
Yes, especially when speaking in public, yes.